Hello everyone. In today's tutorial, we will learn how to create tables in HTML. As we already know that tables are used to arrange data in the form of rows and columns. Whenever we want to present the information in an organized way in the form of rows and columns, we will use the tables. Now, what are the various uses of the table? How the tables help us? First, it provides an attractive way to organize your information. Secondly, it also presents your data in a very comprehensive manner. And thirdly, it also helps us to make the comparisons of data very easy. Now, what are the various tags that can be used to create table in HTML? First tag that we will use is table tag. This tag is used to define a table in HTML. Whenever we want to start the coding for a table, we will start the coding with the table tag. Secondly, we will write the tr tag to define each row in a table. As many rows as you want in a table, you will define all the rows with the help of opening tr tag and close the tr tag at the end of each row. Then we will use the th tag. This tag is used to define the column headings. Whenever we define the column headings with the help of th tag, it makes the text bold. It makes the values of those cells as bold. Then td tag. This tag is used to define the values for each cell in a table. As we know, the table is made up of cells. So each cell value is defined with the help of td tag. Next is structure of table. That means what will be the structure of table or what will be the sequence of HTML code using these tags to create a table. First of all, you will write table to begin the table. Now here from here, I'm going to start the coding for table. Then you will define the first row with the help of tr tag. Now that means my first row begins here. After that, I'm giving the first cell value using the th tag. Cell values can be defined with th and td, both the tags, and th tag is define the value as bold, so that can be used as a column heading. This will be my first cell in the table. Second cell in the first row, third cell in the first row. As many columns as you have in a table, you can continue with the th tag to define the column headings. When you are finished with the number of columns, close the tr tag. That means we are closing the first row here. My first row is finished. Now I'm going to start the second row with the help of again opening tr tag. Okay, now define the next value as td. Td is the normal define the cell value. Again, it is used to define the cell value. Second row, first cell value. But this value will not be bold. Then second value, then third value. All the rows, in the second row, third, all the three values has been defined. Now close the tr tag. Now we can continue with the rows, as many rows as we want. Suppose in the next row, I'm going to define the first value, then second value, then third value, then close the tr tag. And you can continue in the same manner to define the further rows. When you are finished with the table, close the table tag. Now let's write the HTML code for creating a table using an example. Here I had already typed the beginning tags, HTML head, title, close the head tag, body. I had given the BG color as green. Then H1, a heading is defined and underlined it by and type the text result. Now I am starting the coding for table. Start the code with the help of table tag, then define first row, table row. In the beginning, table tag, then first row, tr. After the tr tag, you will define the number of columns. Suppose th, first heading of the column. Suppose it is row number, close the th, then second, suppose name, close th, second heading, second column heading, then third column heading, that means the third cell value in the first row, suppose that is grade, close th, then close the tr tag. This is the first row is defined. First row, then three values in the first row, that means three columns are defined. Then the row is closed by using the closing tag of tr, table row. Now, second row, begin the second row with the opening tr tag. Then define the values in the second row, td. Why we use the td? Td is a normal to define the normal cell values. Th will write the text in bold. That is why they are given in the first row to make the headings as bold. Suppose first row, first value in the second row is, we have to define the roll number. Roll number 1. Close the td. First value in the second row is 1. Then second value, td. What will be the name that will appear in the second row under the name heading? Close td. Then third value, td. Grade. Suppose grade is B+. Close the td tag. Now all the three values has been defined. Then close the tr tag. Okay. Now close table tag. Let's see what will appear on the web browser. After that, we can add the more rows. Then close table tag, close the body tag, and close the HTML tag. Save it. Then go to the browser, open the file, Control O, open it. See. Result heading is displayed. Now table is appearing with the first row, roll number, name, grade as bold because they were defined with the help of th tag. Now second row is also there, one, roll number 1, Akhil, and grade is B+. Now what's the problem here? There is cell borders are not appearing. Cell borders, the borders around the cell or borders around the table are not appearing. For that, we have to use an attribute of table tag. I'm going to give only one attribute in today's tutorial. Rest of the attributes we will do in the next tutorial. Border. You will define the value in the number of pixels. Suppose I'm giving the border as 2. You can give the border as 4, 3, 5, 7, 9, according to the thickness of the border that you want. Here I'm giving table 1 space, define the border value, border equals to 2. Now save it, go to the browser, refresh it. See, borders of 2 pixels will appear. Okay, now you can continue with the rows. You can do the coding with the rows. Suppose I'm going to copy this row, Control C. I'm pasting it here. Now I can change the values here. 2, row number 2. Give the new values in the second row. Suppose A grade. Now I can again paste the row by using the Control V. I'm giving the third row values for the third row. Then give the grade, suppose A+, all the values is defined. You can continue pasting with the rows and changing the values. Save it. Let's see what now appear on web browser. Refresh it. See, all the values had been displayed. Okay. I hope you understand the HTML code to create table. Now I'm giving you one assignment. A table is given on your screen. It is displayed on your screen. Now write the HTML code to create this table. Thank you.